Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back from this quick commercial break. Guys started it earlier. Envious is eager to jump back into this. We've got Biolab capture the flag. Both teams have the enemy flag. It's a standoff. Stalemate to begin. Your flag carrier for the guys over on Envious is Nameless. He's going to be holding on to the flag. And across the way is Lawless trying to stay alive for a wear.
All right, yeah, we're going to have a bit of a standoff here to start things early. We'll see who's going to be able to clutch this one up as he's got a little coverage here from his teammate. You know, this top base position is so huge for either team. It's a great spot to defend from. Also, if you're on the attack trying to pull that flag, great position as well. But thanks to the COD vision, we can kind of see most players kind of playing defensively right now, sort of covering their sides. Not a ton of pressure. Like, just look at the minimap. No one's really trying to go for the other flag at all.
Not at all. Actually, we're going to switch on where there's a little more action over here on the side of Aware. It's going to be, I believe it was Lawless. Yeah, holding on to the flag. Here comes the pressure, though, across the way. Nice pickup by the flag carrier. Actually, flag carrier is going to go down and re-picked up there by Merc. The flag's going to go down here. Nice kill. That was actually Clayster who got the pickup.
Oh, that show.
Flag, no! Right before he jumps in, that flag's going to be down. Rotating back to grab it.
Oh, no, my God!
Kirsten
Sender got both of them.
And he finally jumped in with it. That's going to be a cap for the guys from Team Envious. Finally jumping that one in. Inches. They just inched it in.
If Sender got that return with two kills within a foot of the cap, that would have been absolutely absurd. But there's going to be a big kill out of Clayster. Should be able to get... Oh, actually, no, they did get another touch. He's trying to get the shots in. Sees a player there up above. Might push window, but he's going to take shots from the behind and eventually drop it. Good start for him. They needed this 1-0 lead. They really did. But who's this push return? That's Nameless, not able to get it.
Flag's going to be down. Picked up right again by Sender. Big gunfight over here. It's actually going to be Merc. He's going to be able to pick up the kill. Actually, he's going to turn on that block X ability. Trying to get over. Nice positioning top roof. Taken still, flag goes down though. He's gonna jump out of the flag. Will he go for the return as well? Finds one, can't get the second, he will drop. Still 1-0, Envious on top.
Yeah, that was difficult. They kind of had a player on either side there. Obviously, he was pulling, had a guy across Snell. They got that spawn basically right there at those middle steps. He didn't really have anywhere to go at all with the flag, but they did get the big return there. Still hold the 1-0 lead. Again, if you are just tuning in, it's a 2-0 advantage right now for Aware. Envy has got to get something going. They need some energy because they are struggling right now.
Down there momentarily for Aware. Of course, capture the flag. You know, this replaced Blitz, obviously. If you've been a fan of Black Ops 2, you know how capture the flag works. Blitz is being played for some sneak caps. You necessarily need to not kill everybody. You don't necessarily need to kill everybody. Capture the flag is about getting everybody, as many people as down as you can. And while they're in that respawn, pull that flag, get it across, set up to have the cutoffs, because when they do respawn, they're going to be coming at you. And get that flag to your base right now. Envious, textbook team, they've been playing basically with this almost relatively same squad in these game types.
Yeah.
So they understand exactly how to play this right now.
I'll tell you what, it's just crazy to watch this game compared to Ghost. I mean, when you think about it, typically in Ghost, if you ever saw a player from the side or behind, it's pretty much a guaranteed kill. We've seen some gunfights just with these exo abilities and with the movement in this game. It is like Merc missed a couple bullets and then just got absolutely destroyed earlier. But this should be the tying cap. No one in a position to stop that at all. 1-1, just over a minute to go here.
I would have liked to have seen a 360 jump into the cap.
Yeah, that would be kind of nice. A little flashy 360 no scope flag cap.
Yeah. He's going phase after this.
That's certain.
We're tied up.
Phase flag caps.
Great start here for Sender. 11-7. He's going to find another one. And actually, we're actually on board with accuracy, but accuracy is going to clean up that kill. Sender's having an incredible game so far. Aware is able to stay into this one. Accuracy finally taken out. Flag's going to be pulled yet again by Lawless. This is an unpopular way to take this flag. He's got his work cut out for him. The spawn is going to be on this side typically. Right now, Team Envious is going to be. He will be taken out. That flag will be returned. 30 seconds remain. I don't think we're going to see a cap before the attack.
Yeah, that, like you said, I mean, this map, how is he alive? Cap is getting his boots on, trying to get
out
across here.
He's all out of overclock, though. He's got 13 seconds.
And both flags are out. They got to pull, too.
He's got to find the kill here. He's expecting the player from Aware to be inside. He's going to try to play this one cautiously. 6 seconds. He'll hang out on the roof. Hopefully, they can get the return. They just might be able to. He's got a teammate.
There it is.
They do get the return right before the clock expires, and Team Envious does go up 2-1 over Aware right before the half.
I'll tell you what, if they manage to pull this one out and then come back in this series after the 6-0 dismantling we just saw in SMB, you know,
they can do it though.
Oh, they absolutely can.
Team Envious is a team that can do that, 100%.
Oh, I certainly agree. And, you know, we talk about for every really Call of Duty game, S&D is the one that wins championships. You know, you have two S&Ds in every single best of five. And, you know, I said last game, like, this S&D is what we didn't really know what to expect so much from a lot of these teams coming into land, because you don't have time in, what, 3 weeks from release to get a ton of strats and have all these this complicated meta that hasn't even developed yet. You know, it's pretty raw right now as far as the game type goes.
EMPs for days. Four down for Envious. Senders on your screen. I'll pull up your minimap. Flag finally will be taken. Lawless is one to grab it. Setting up the center. We talked about the cutoff.
Oh, God.
Senders, stop. He's only got 11 bullets left in his clip. Just kidding, he did pick up. Actually, was he running extended mags? Let's take a look at his class for a second here.
Just so you know, if you're watching this for the first time, maybe in the Oracle view, you actually, in broadcaster mode with the right D-pad now, we can kind of show you a little bit of additional stuff as far as teams, equipment, and, you know, what a tap in, attachments, perks. It's fantastic. So we got fast hands, marathon, blast suppressor. And, oh, the gunfight, not able to win that one. So flag is going to be down right now. It is tied up 2-2, though.
Easy pick up, and Blair's able to tie this up yet again. They've been able to deliver it right now to Team Envious. 14-11 center. Slower start right now. That one finally does get taken out. Two down for both squads. Here comes accuracy, though, working towards the flag. We'll be able to pick it up. Gonna try to be alive. We've got players from Envious all over the face. Eats like 17 EMPs and three down, four aware.
3.5 left to play, all tied up. This is looking a lot more like our game number one, really, is what it's seeming like now. And did we get the...
It's not letting me click.
We're good. Might have just been lagging. All right, I'm not sure what all happened there, because I looked over to my screen. He was running in one spot, so.
We're good now.
Classy.
Though. Classy. In the meantime, there was a score for Envious. 3-2 now. Sorry we missed that. I don't know exactly what happened there, but I was like, why can't I click on anything? 18-13, though, here for Merc. Great start for the team captain. You're actually going to see Nameless on your screen. He's going to kind of post up the building here. Great building. He's going to find another one. Can he pick up this kill? He does. Dynamic map elements. That's what's so interesting about this game. Have they been blowing them up? Yeah, they've been blowing up these canisters every chance they get. That way, they're not going to make it.
Yeah, you should. You really want to get rid of those as often as you can. But we'll stay on here with him. We'll see if he can pick up a couple kills.
Jump out this window.
Someone knows he's home. He has a player right behind him. Yeah, going to get cleaned up. Tried to get that little sneak pull there, but like you said, does get tracked down. Taking a look over the KDs. It's going to be Merc leading the way right now on a 2-streak at 20-14. Big kills on the board. Nobody else really reached that 20 kill mark, but just looking across between either team, pretty evenly matched.
You beat the line out here. 5-1. No!
Oh,
Sender! How many times will Sender do this?
And that's what I'm saying. That is what I love about this game. This is not Call of Duty Ghost. You are not L-triggering and staring at a corner. Yeah. You really got to hit shots, especially when it comes to the vertical play. You haven't really had a Call of Duty in the past where you had to be so aware in gunfights of so many different angles, and you've watched some people just get abused from either side in this matchup.
The routes out of Happy here. Here comes another dynamic map element. This building being added to the side of Envious. He's going to try to stay alive here. Aware, not going to be able to. That flag's going to be down, but we'll return as well. Envious able to get the return. 1:30 remaining. Aware down by one flag gap. Have to work that out. Envious kind of turtling their base just a little bit. You kind of see Nameless hanging out in that building almost his entire half.
Yeah, we got to see, though. They got to try and get a pull here. Like you mentioned, not a ton of time. They're starting to get – who are we watching right now? We're on with Lawless. So, yeah, he's the one that started a little bit in game one, got it going absolutely in game two. Got a heck of a game going here in game three, but they've got to try and get a touch. I do like when you look at the minimap, you see that Envy is not playing. They're not turtling. You can't turtle. You got to at least try and hold that mid-map area, which for the most part they're trying to do. But you got three down right now. Could it be four? I think that was basically all four dropped in a matter of seconds there. We should be able to try and get a pull here. Can he win this gunfight? Sender gets hit markers, but eventually going to drop.
Black is going to get pulled, though. Accuracy is just going to tie immediately. Nice pick up there for Lawless. He's going to try to get this flag. 30 seconds remaining. It's all go for Aware. Sender drops. Let's see if Happy can pull this flag out. Happy's had an incredible series so far against Team Envious. Time's going to be dwindling down. Eats an EMP immediately here in purple. Allows the teammates to try to get it. No, Envious, though, meanwhile, still applying the pressure at the base. Saw Black go there for a moment. It was actually by Nameless. Here it comes. There's not enough time to get the flag over. Envious will capture the flag against Aware, and that's going to keep their series alive. Aware still up 2-1 now after this map.
They needed that. Got to get a little bit of life. You know, we saw a shot of the team here. High fives around. Got to get a little bit of energy going. You see the monster there for Nameless. Merc all smiles. You saw some laugh. You know, that's what you like. With a team that's really comfortable with each other, you talk about, you have those squads that when they go down, they really struggle. Just teams that can't really fight out of the depths when they get into a big hole. Envy right now, definitely a team, I think, just with their chemistry, the fact that the three of those players have been playing together so long, certainly a team that can crawl out of this. But the next game type, you know, I mentioned how I feel S&D in this game is going to be so important because it's still really raw. Just hasn't been a lot of time spent on it. But our game number four is the one in which I think we're really going to see some tricks.
We're going to see some major tricks.
Yeah, this is going to be like Space Jam up in here. You're going to see shots coming from mid-map. You know, I saw a thing of Burns the other day. He was in a game by himself, no bots, just practicing his jump shots.
He's just practicing.
It was 201-0 in his game.
No, S&D, we can't stress it enough how S&D obviously does win championships, but that's the thing that's kind of scary about Team Envious is the fact that when you think of game types and you think about strong game types for Team Envious, historically, you always think of S&D. It's in the roots, especially when Rambo was on the team, Merc continuing it on, JCap. This is an S&D squad, and the fact that they just got 6-0'd in S&D worries me when we do, if we do go to that game five.
Yeah.
Biolab is going to be the map. We're going right back to it, but we're going to be playing Uplink next for the first time on stream here at the Advanced Warfare Open at MLG Columbus. Guys, don't go anywhere. We got more action coming right up.